We've already talked about essential and non-essential amino acids, and for today's video, I want to highlight a 21st amino acid. But before we do that, we have to turn to the periodic table and talk about an element known as selenium, which is abbreviated as SE. Now, selenium is a metalloid, meaning that it has properties of both metals and nonmetals, and it's an essential trace nutrient in order to make that 21st amino acid known as selenocysteine, which has a structure that looks like this, and it's very similar to another amino acid known as cysteine, but instead of having sulfur present here, it instead has selenium. So when ribosomes are reading our mRNA and they come in contact with a selenocysteine incorporation sequence, as they're building a protein, they will incorporate selenocysteine into that growing polypeptide chain. That will create a certain type of protein known as a selenoprotein. And there's only a few in our bodies, and I want to highlight two of them today. One of them is known as glutathione peroxidase, or GPX, and that helps to protect us from oxidative stress and reactive oxygen species. Another example is known as iodothyronine deiodinase, or DIO1 or 2, which helps to convert inactive thyroid hormones to active thyroid hormones. So the next time someone tells you that there's only 20 amino acids in order to build proteins, make sure you tell them you know about the 21st amino acid known as selenocysteine. And make sure to stay connected to my channel and with Dane Garvin as we continue breaking down other scientific topics.